At Game X, just outside of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Our live chat for today, we are here with cast members from the Guild. We have Robin Thorsen, Jeff Lewis, Sandeep Parikh.
Hello.
The good ones, in other words. Yeah, it's
the good ones.
The good ones. So what do you guys think of Game X so far? Good?
Yeah, I'm having a good time. It's a lot of fun.
Having a great time. Everybody's been really nice and got to play a lot of games.
Yeah.
I hate this place.
They're playing,
I'm lying. I don't know. Nobody can hear.
Sorry.
What?
We only have one microphone, so I have to.
Oh, okay.
So you're on microphone duty.
Huh? I'm on microphone duty, yeah. I said I hate this place, but I was just kidding. I want to make that clear that I was joking.
Well, what, Philadelphia beat you up as a child or something? What?
Yes, the city of Philadelphia beat me up as a child.
The city of Philadelphia killed my father.
Yeah. I mean, so we're back here to make a man, I don't know. What is it? Face our demons?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Face your demons. Yeah. Go through the shadow.
Go into the wormhole.
Exactly. we are drunk. What? Here we go.
I don't know. So we got questions, actually. The viewers are typing questions into their IRC. So we're not, and then, you know, they're giving them to me, and then I'm giving them to you. We actually got some already. Yeah. The first question was, what was the first MMO you've ever played? Go.
Oh my god, I played EverQuest on PlayStation, the first PlayStation.
Yeah.
That was my first.
Mine was Warcraft, the first time I ever signed online and played with other actual humans. But I used to play, other RPGs, you know, like Ultima.
Somebody's going to want to know what your Warcraft character is, of course.
I play a character called Zabudi. it's a gnome warlock. It was researched for the role. And I don't know.
Zabu was taken when he tried to sign on. So.
Someone else took Zabu already.
Nice.
So I went with Zabudi. I thought that was funnier anyway.
Can you go after him for squatting? You know, or character squatting.
Can I see that guy?
Yeah.
Good point. I'm gonna get my lawyers on it. I'm gonna sick my lawyers on that.
I'll give you a card later.
You'll be my lawyer?
No. But I know one. He's good.
Awesome.
As long as you know one. I played, and I actually played Vork, which is a Night Elf warrior.
Nice.
I can't believe you actually got Vork.
I know, I can't believe it was there. It tells you how original Felicia is.
I guess so.
I don't play.
You don't play. Well, you got a movie coming out next year, right? Tell us a little bit about your movie.
It's called Perfect Match, and I have just a tiny part, but I actually I got the role because of the Guild. The casting director knew me from the Guild, so.
Oh, because you're one of the good ones.
That's correct.
Yeah.
I like that. Yeah, so check that out. It's called Perfect Combination.
About this.
I don't like you very much, so I don't really tell you stuff.
Good point. You make good points.
That's making me nervous.
And Sandeep wins.
Okay. So is there any truth to the rumor of, you know, the cast infighting? And, you know, actually, I heard everybody hates Sandeep, but I like it.
Really?
No, it's fine, man.
Was I not supposed to say anything about that?
What did I tell you?
I'm sorry, I thought he knew.
I was urinating next to you and you told me.
Now this is awkward.
It's awkward now.
Awkward.
We've got to continue with the show.
It's awkward now. I'm sorry.
I have to leave. I have to go cry in a closet.
We can cut away if you need to do that. You can stay. No, you can stay.
Either way, he would go away and cry. It doesn't really...
The damage is done. Yeah,
yes.
I'm sorry.
I don't... Okay.
Holding the microphone earlier.
Well, the guy dealt you. Don't tell me. Okay, I'm aware of it now.
So, Jeff, since you have the microphone, tell us a little bit about your stand-up routine. Apparently, you do it in character.
The Vork, yeah, I did it at BlizzCon. They asked me to do just a few minutes, and it was really fun. And I did it again. It got a great response. I was really shocked.
Yeah.
8,000.
Yeah, I wasn't told that it was 8,000. I thought a couple hundred, not even 100. I thought maybe 40 or 50.
Right.
Like 12.
Yeah.
And then I walked through the audience in the beginning. I was like, holy mackerel, there's literally 8,000 people here. But I had index cards, so it was easy.
Yeah.
And then we did a show with Paul and Storm where I did stand up again, and we did an acoustic version of Do You Want to Date My Avatar, which was fun.
Right.
So that was good.
Good signs.
Yep. Jeff wins. You weren't competing against anybody, and you still won.
So Sandeep, Legend of Neo is really taking off, and it's going well. What can you tell us about what's in store for you there?
Well, we just finished season two, which we're really happy with, and the response has been unbelievable. I mean, season one was great, but I think we almost tripled our viewership from season to season two. We did a musical in season two, which we were happy about. So we're hoping that because of that response, I mean, Comedy Central is really excited, and we want to do a season three. I think both sides are going to try to get something done and make it happen. So, follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and we'll keep you updated.
Awesome. Cool. Well, speaking of new seasons, The Guild season four, what can you tell us? What's in store?
So season four, well, we're still rolling out season three.
Yeah.
We still got four more episodes of that.
Yeah.
So we're
going
to bask in that glory before worrying about four, I think. But also, Felicia's working on a Guild comic book with Dark Horse,
right?
Which is cool. I don't know. Nothing's set in stone in terms of a season four, but I think that assuming that the response will be good as it was for season two and as it has been so far for season three, I think that there'll probably be more. But there's nothing.
And they're also focusing on season three DVD, which they add a bunch of stuff, and so that's in the works too.
So is anybody, are we going to lose any characters? Is anybody going to get killed? Like lost, you know?
What's that? Is anybody getting killed?
Yeah.
On an airplane and land on an island.
I heard something. I don't, I'm not sure if I was supposed to share it or not, but yeah.
Yeah.
What are you going to do? We're going to check up with the next season with John Cryer and Charlie Sheen. And he's going to be 2.5 men and
the Bubble Boy.
And the Guild.
Yeah. And the Guild. And Will Wheaton.
Guild! Yeah, it'll be awesome. Let's see what see if we have any more questions in from our community.
Very awkwardly.
They want to know what's your best procrastination advice?
Device?
Advice.
Advice.
Yeah.
How to procrastinate?
Yeah.
Watch the Guild. Watch Legend of Neo.
World of Warcraft.
That's a pretty good one.
Yeah.
I think that one wins. Play World of Warcraft.
Yeah.
Play a lot of Xbox.
Yeah. We just got Xboxes. Xboxes plural.
Is it boxes?
Xbox I.
Is it
that
box
the plural?
In?
The greatest thing is the Netflix feature, where you can see on demand anything.
Yeah.
I mean, that is a huge, that's like a procrastination machine. I mean, it's just built for any form of procrastination.
I hear you can watch the Guild on that, too.
Yeah.
You can watch the Guild.
Did we mention that you should watch the Guild if you want to procrastinate? I don't know if we mentioned that earlier.
So I don't want to
watch the Guild, actually.
I don't want to be around the bush. I
already know that.
You really should watch the
Guild.
Wait,
hang on. There. What is the strangest thing you have ever been asked to sign?
Felicia signed a boob.
Felicia signed a boob. Her own?
The craziest thing, someone brought a baby.
Oh, yeah.
They didn't ask me to sign the baby, and I was hoping they would ask me to sign the baby. But then later, because I kind of mentioned it a bunch, someone finally came up and was like, if you want to sign my baby, you can sign my baby. I was like, I can't actually sign your baby. I can't do it. I was like, if the baby's old enough to ask to be signed, then if it was the baby's consent. But we held the baby. Yeah.
So you didn't sign it.
No, but we signed some. I signed an old NES. That was kind of cool. Like someone chucked that around. I think they signed a Commodore 64.
Our shield. Remember Comic-Con?
Well, they made the Horde emblem.
They made
us all Horde emblems. That was kind of cool. Yeah, people. Our fans are amazing. They make stuff for us. It's so cool.
Yeah.
There's funny YouTube stuff where they do a tribute to the Guild using the Friends opening and the Office opening. I mean, it's really funny.
The Office one.
Yeah, the fans are really creative. It's nice to see the love come back, right?
It's amazing. Yeah.
So how often do you guys do a show like this?
A show like what?
Like Game X or an appearance like this.
Oh, a con. Yeah, I mean, I've done about 8 this year. I mean, this year's been the biggest year. It's grown.
Yeah.
The first year only did like a couple, and then we all did Comic-Con. We all did Comic-Con last year, And that went really well. We didn't have a panel or anything, but then this year we had a panel, and it was, you know, actually Comic-Con didn't believe that we would sell out a room, so they gave us the smallest room possible, which is a 500-person room,
yeah.
And we jammed that room, and we had to turn away,
yeah.
We had to turn away another 500 or so people. So, nice. I mean, that sort of spurred on getting invited to a lot of these other conventions like GameX, and we did PAX, BlizzCon, we've done BlizzCon for 2 years,
yeah.
That's really fun.
Oh yeah, that's it. I'm trying to think of others we did. I guess it's.
I did Kineticon, Houston, which we won't mention. We won't mention that. there's been some good ones and some bad ones.
Yeah.
This one's a really good one. I mean, these guys. This is their first year, and I'm impressed by how well they.
Everybody's very nice.
Yeah. Been very very nice to us here too.
Yeah,
this is a good experience.
So
they wanted to know, how long does it usually take to film an episode of The Guild?
We get this one a lot.
Yeah.
Well, we block shoot. The last two scenes we block shot, so that means we shot over a period of 2 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks. We shoot all the episodes at once and all the locations, and then we edit. And then Sean Becker, our director editor, goes back and edits them. So there's no real good way to answer that question.
No, it used to be the first year we shot just on weekends when we could. Now it's a very rigid, you know, we do a 2 week schedule.
Now it's a job.
Yeah.
Is it more or less fun now that it's a job?
It's still fun.
I think it's really fun. I mean, the characters are really fleshed out. And so, you know, Felicia's found a way to really, she's, in the years, in the all the episodes she's done, she's really been able to get as much as she can, and just, we just can do a lot more.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
really fun.
Agreed.
So what are your favorite?
I think we all won that round. Russ lost. That's all we know.
Lost. I can't work like that.
I can't. Oh.
What?
We'll take it from here.
Yeah. It's like, rat. So what's your, this one came in from the viewers. So what's some of your favorite internet series aside from The Guild or Legend of Neil?
That's a good question.
I really love Children's Hospital. Which I don't know if it's
so great. I don't know where that went.
Yeah. It was really funny. Those the guys from Stella.
Stuff.
Is that right? No, that's Dave.
I'm horrible with names.
Okay.
Are you?
It's a funny show.
So it's Rob Corddry.
Yeah.
It's his thing. Obviously we love Dr. Horrible.
Yeah.
The crew's pretty good. I enjoyed it.
You're gonna be on an episode.
I was on two episodes of
the show. Oh, what's your character?
Oh, and I'm gonna be coming out, I'm gonna be in a new web series called Squatters. Which I'm really excited about, with the guy who plays the male fairy, Brendan Bradley, in Legend of Neil, wrote me a part, and it was really funny, and so that's going to be coming out soon.
Cool.
Jeff, you were in There Will Be Brawl.
I was in There Will Be Brawl, and I was in Dorm Life, which was fun.
Yeah. Oh yeah, Dorm Life is really funny.
Yeah.
Okay.
What else is funny? There's so many funny things. I feel bad.
There's
I feel like
lot,
I'm...
There's a lot of funny stuff.
I actually do really love Zero Punctuation. I'm not just saying that because you're here.
Guy's a hack.
Oh
wait, there he is.
He's very funny. Yeah. No, he's very funny.
Gosh,
there's so much stuff.
Yeah.
I actually really love like everything that Alex Albrecht does. I love Dignation and the Totally Rad Show and stuff like that.
Those guys,
I mean, those aren't
there.
Really like, those are more hosted shows.
Yeah.
And Epic Foo from with Zaddy, she's amazing.
Sean, our director, has a show called Comedy Gumbo.
Oh, that's also
that's very funny.
Wow. So what did you guys think of the Streamy Awards? Y'all were there, right?
Yeah, the Streamy.
Yeah.
The Streamies were fun, yeah.
Yeah.
We sat right behind Joss Whedon, and that was really cool.
That was awesome.
That alone was nice.
That was insane when he turned around to us and, you know, actually said, like, I'm a big fan, and nice to see you, and all that stuff.
Yeah, he came...
What the heck? What? Like,
that's nice.
He came up to me quoting the Legend, and he quoted the skeletons in Legend Neil, and I just about lost my poop. I mean, I don't know if I can swear on this.
Yeah, it was bad. It was bad.
Yeah, had to wipe it. He came up to me and he was quoting, like, when Joss Whedon is quoting a show that you've written, it's just, I mean, it's unbelievable. So
that's awesome.
Hey, the whole experience was great. The two filter guys who put that on are super nice guys, and I couldn't believe. I mean, I thought this was gonna be like in like some room of like, you know, maybe a couple hundred people, but it was
huge.
A red carpet. It was.
Yeah.
Crazy big hall, and
we won a lot of awards, so it was great too.
And so, yeah, and then there's that too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's nice
but
to
it's
win.
Not about the awards. It's just a thrill to be nominated.
No, I want we.
It's about the awards, yeah. It's about winning. It's all about winning.
It's all about the hardware, baby.
It's all about the heartbreak. So another question just came in. So is Tink coming back to the Knights?
Well, we can't answer that question. You have to keep watching.
I almost answered you.
I know, man. That was close. That was close.
I almost answered you. But I can't say.
So let's get another one. So what are some of your influences as performers?
I was raised on Steve Martin. I mean, he was so silly. And so, you know, like you could almost do anything as long as you're committed to it. And it's hilarious.
Yeah.
Just really funny.
It's a good one.
Meryl Streep, obviously. I mean, for me, who else? Madeline Kahn. I love her.
Yeah.
She's just hilarious. Gilda Radner. I mean, really.
Yeah.
Funny ladies.
All those famous Indian actors that you, all those famous ones. there are ones in all those English-speaking. You know, remember those guys?
I remember Peter Sellers playing an Indian guy in the party.
Oh, you know the guy in Short Circuit 2, who plays, because they couldn't hire an Indian guy. He was amazing. He's my major influence.
Yeah.
And what's that guy's name?
Who was that kid was Asian. Sorry.
Jackie Chan, is that who you're trying to think of? Yeah. No, he's not Indian.
That helped out Indiana Jones. He was like 12 years old.
Dr. Jones.
Was he Indian? I thought he was Micronesian, actually.
He was Micronesian.
Yeah.
Yeah, you could, that's a very discerning eye you have.
I'm in the business. So we get this question for every live chat. What games are you guys currently playing?
Well, I like to play God of War. I'm looking forward to the new one of that. I actually like a lot of the PopCap games. I'm a huge kind of casual gamer. Castle Crashers is fun. Zuma. I get addicted to those games, and it's nice because you can't, like, I mean, MMOs as much fun as they are. Like, you have to do a lot of work. It feels like it's this giant to-do list, and like I have this work to do. But like, you know, with Zuma or something, I can just come in and blast off some balls shooting out of a frog's mouth for about 10 minutes and then walk away from it, you know?
If you take that sentence out of context,
blasting balls out of a frog's mouth?
Even if you take it out of context, it's still okay.
Yeah, it's a little off.
I play World of Warcraft still, and a lot of Xbox. A new game we play called Trials, which is a scrolling game, motorcycle. Yeah. And
Excite Bike for today. I love that game.
So fun, yeah. And Castle Crashers and Shadow Complex, and we just started playing Left 4 Dead.
Oh yeah,
it's very fun.
Good time.
Yeah, it's really fun.
Yeah.
Never play Left 4 Dead with Felicia Day. She'll give you a heart attack. Cause she just screams
like a little girl. I mean, she's a little girl, but she screams.
A foul-mouthed little girl. I mean, really, it's like she's. I think she's literally afraid that zombies will come out of the television and kill us. Like, I mean, it's absurd.
Well, speaking of little girl, didn't Will Wheaton scream like a little girl in your presence?
Poor Will. Poor Will. He's a manly, you know, he's a dude. But then that's the one thing everybody talks about. I mean, I feel bad for him. Yeah, it was a giant bug, all right, to be fair.
Yeah.
It was like fist.
Four different times.
You know, at one point, they didn't show this, but Mike Rose, in the middle of the take, caught the bug, held it for the entire take.
Wow.
And then let it go at the end of the take. Yeah.
Well, it was like a Howard Dean moment, you know? It ruined him, you know? Like that.
It was pretty funny.
Poor Will. Yeah, poor Will.
Yeah, poor Will.
Poor Will. So what are you playing now, Robin?
Oh, geez, I'm not like...
You have a DS.
I play my DS. I play, you know, Mario Kart and all that, Super Mario, and
So you guys are obviously talented improv artists. Is there a lot of
go on?
Is there a lot of ad libbing that goes on when in filming the guild, or is that heavily scripted and somebody's there, you know, with a gun?
The entire thing is ad libbed.
All of it.
I don't think there's no script, right?
Richard just says go, and that's what we do.
Oh. Wow.
No, that's not true at all. There's a script that we all follow. That we generally do tape. It's hard to necessarily get a ton of time to ad lib on set because things are moving quickly. We're generally fighting the clock or the sun going down. So, but we get our fair share in there. I mean, they give us some takes to like come up with new lines, or with every take you can do a new line at the end. You know, that kind of thing. But we do a lot of our ad-libbing before we ever shoot at a table read. We generally read it through once, and then we'll read it through again and ad-lib a little bit there. And Felicia will be writing the script notes down so she can get a lot of those ad-libs into the new version of the script before we shoot. That seems to be our best way of functioning for the guild, yeah.
And one of the fun things that is when I watch an episode for the first time on Xbox, I never exactly know what take they're going to use that's going to have either an improvised line or an actual line or another alt line. It's kind of fun to see what they chose.
Yeah, you know, what they actually come up with.
Yeah, what they actually finally did, pick, you know, chose for the final.
No, complete that sentence.
Have there ever been any like really big surprises in that regard? Like, has it been an episode you've seen and you're like, oh wow, I can't believe they did that?
I feel like there was one I just saw.
Yeah, you were.
I can't remember, but I.
Is it the one where Tink comes back to the Knights?
That was close. Oh, that was close.
Hey!
I can't remember what it is, but I remember I was. Oh, that's the one they used. It was funny.
Oh, you know, in the first season, in the episode where I came in shirtless.
Yeah.
I did. That was one where I just did a different line every single time. I did about 10 of those, and I think those were all in the outtakes. So I had no idea what they were going to choose for that. And I'm really glad to see. You know, I thought it was funny what they chose, and I really love the outtake that they put at the end of the episode, the magic carpet. I actually started breaking out and singing the Aladdin song, which I think didn't make it into the. Sadly.
Oh, I know what it was. We made up a bunch of names of drive-through restaurants. and we had like five or six, and then they finally picked like Mr. Chicken Stuff Jr. and Friends.
It's like the longest one, right?
Yeah. So that was kind of fun to see what they finally settled on.
That's awesome.
And I think a lot of credit has to go to Sean Becker, the editor. I mean, Felicia and Kim, I'll help him as well, like oversee it. But Sean's our director, editor, and he does an amazing job. Like, yeah, oh, all the credit in the world. He doesn't get enough credit, honestly.
We've gotten really like used to him, and we. And it's really been very comfortable and a good fit.
Well, he knows our humor too. He appreciates it.
Yeah. Speaking of being comfortable, there've been a lot of costumes here, a lot of cosplaying and various things. Some make me uncomfortable. What's the craziest costume you guys have seen here at Game
today?
X? Yeah, today.
Bigfoot. Like I had a Bigfoot costume. He actually kind of has become a buddy of ours, this dude, Joe.
He played Rock Band with us.
Awesome. What did he play? Did he play bass?
Bigfoot played Rock Band. Bass, yeah.
Yeah, well, of course.
Right. What would Bigfoot play?
What else would, yeah.
Yeah.
Bigfoot does not have rhythm for drums.
His giant Bigfoot would crush the drum.
He can't sing anything but just growls.
That's kind of how I sing, too. That's how I sounded today. It's not because I'm hungover, I promise you.
What? No.
We don't drink. What are you talking about?
Straight edge. Yeah, hey, don't do any drugs or drinking, children.
Stay in school.
Drink plenty of liquids, like 8 ounces of water a day or something.
I said don't do any drinking. That's not appropriate.
You have to survive, yeah.
No, please nourish yourself, children. Sorry, we're going off on an absurd tangent.
Oh, we got there's one last question, actually. Just time for one more. We're actually running the Escapist Film Festival, third annual this year at the Escapist. Some of the viewers wanted to know if you guys have any advice for people just starting out in web video, maybe want to eventually be the next Sandeep, Parikh, or Robin, or Jeff.
You know, I always say, buy my book. No. The Way Things Are Done on the Web by Sandeep Parikh. I think the biggest thing about the Guild and Legend of Neil and the reason why they're successful is because they come from a really real place, a genuine place, a genuine love for whether it's, you know, video games and MMOs or Zelda. I mean, it comes from a place where, you know, it's the old adage, you know, write what you know. And something that's unique, you know, and don't be afraid to take that chance. I mean, I don't think that you'd ever see on television a show necessarily about Zelda specifically, and clearly we got a lot of resistance from networks to do the Guild on television because they didn't quite get it. But that's the beauty of the web, is that you get to do what you want to do because your audience is out there, you know, and you can have that one-on-one relationship with them. You know, whether it's through Twitter or Facebook or whatever, and all these social networking tools, is you can find your niche. So do what you really love and make sure that that's that's, you know, if you try to emulate something that's already out there or what's, you know, already successful, then I think that becomes false and it doesn't quite come through. I think that's the other thing, is that the authenticity, I mean, that on the web, I mean, that's why people love video blogs and stuff like that, because people are being real, they're being themselves, and I think that's, the web promotes that in a way that no other medium does.
And I think, you know, the writing is so important. I think it's what separates the good stuff from the bad stuff, the concept, and I think really just get the writing down solid and, you know, show everybody, you know, people you know, whose opinion you respect, their opinions, and get feedback and notes to make it the best script it can be. I think that's really important.
Yeah, and good sound. Shoot with good sound.
Yeah, good sound.
I think the number one technical thing is, like, please buy a mic, boom. Don't just use your camera mic. And then my last piece of advice would be just do it. Just all these things we just said, don't let them hang you up, you know? Like, shoot something. You'll see the first episode of The Guild and the first episode of Legend Neil are far less technically sound than the rest, you know? I mean, you get better and better as you go along, and that's the only way you're going to get better is by just, you know, making it happen.
Have fun, I would say.
Be yourself. Do what you love.
Yeah.
Just do it.
There you go. Just do
awesome.
It.
Great
Nike.
Advice. Well, obviously, sound advice. Yeah. Love you guys. All right, and that's going to be it for us. We are signing off. I got Robin, Jeff, Sandeep from the Guild, Legend of Neil, all kinds of other things. You guys are stars. Thank you very much.
Thanks
for joining us.
Thanks for having us, guys.
Appreciate it. Bye. And now they're rolling credits, so we can just talk and wave while they're rolling credits. Yeah, and you know, we can have the chatter. Yeah. So here's the thing I couldn't tell you while they were going. It's a big secret. I know, right? Yeah.
And you always think it's like you're almost having a better time after the thing. And, you know. Yeah.